video was made possible by EA Game Changers.
Welcome back to Joy's Creative Finger, and a special thanks to EA Fire Monkeys for providing me with early access to the latest update. A new event is here, and it's called the Family Furnishings Live Event, starting July the 16th for 9 days. Okay, it says 8, but trust me, it's 9 days. I'm a day late into starting the preview. Okay, now we have to make some arts and crafts as usual. If you're new to this event, well, of course, you're going to see how this is done. When you head to your normal gameplay, there will be a notification prompting you to bring out some crafting stations. So the candle stations are the only ones that are unlocked at this time. And as you progress, you will be able to unlock the other crafting stations. Now put down all four at once, we always say this, and get four Sims working at once. This allows for you to unlock the maximum amount of candles at this stage in one go, and that's 50 candles in 23 seconds. So all four of them are ready, and that gives us 200 candles, unlocking the very first prize. And typically this is the case in my experience every single time. So here we are, and you can see we've unlocked everything because this is a preview build. It's not my game. I'm going to have to start like everyone else when it goes live, but I can see some beautiful items here, and I think the real question is how much they're going to cost after the first item is put down for free. So let's get started with the peach wall, and we're going to go ahead and put it down in this house that I've put together for this live event. Don't forget to look in the description down below in this video for links to other videos associated with this update. The sim chases and the new pregnancy pack and so on. Okay, this house has been put together for all those items. Now this is the wall that you would unlock, certainly not the floor, and it's a nice color. Let's go on and get the penchant for pendant lights. Those look really lovely. I've been hoping for, you know, more chandeliers and things like that, just to make the build even more pretty. So we're just going to place them up in this section here where I've placed a mezzanine, because they're quite long, well, lengthy. And let's place the other one here. And then we have the prices: 72,000 for the white pendant and 5 social points for the black one. Okay, let's turn them on. They're really lovely. Quite lengthy too. I don't see this being possible to sit down in one floor. You've got to go a floor above with a mezzanine for a realistic look. But it's quite pretty as well. Well, these are pendants anyway. There are some chandeliers to set down here. Droplet chandelier. These look very nice. Let's have a closer look and just purchase them. And let's go over to this mezzanine space here. Let's put down the silver one in this corner. It would cost 85,000 simoleons for the next one. The grey one will go in this spot here, and it's 8 life points for it if you want it again. That's not so much. You know, usually that would be about, I don't know, 50 life points or something crazy like that. I'm okay with that price for this one anyway. They're gorgeous, beautiful, they look quite elegant as well. Let's purchase the clean living pack and set them downstairs. Thin pine wardrobe goes here. 100,000 for the next one. The walnut will go in this corner here. 14 life points for the next one. The walnut ladder shelf will go beside the walnut wardrobe, and the pine ladder shelf will go beside the pine wardrobe. And here you can take note of the prices that follow for the next one that you would purchase, assuming. Right, The wardrobes are interactive, as is the bookshelf, but what is new is that we have other age groups when you click on it. What Sims Freeplay has done is add a new way to view cast content that you've earned for age groups that are not yet unlocked. It's particularly relevant for the Teen Retreat Sim Chase event, allowing players to participate and unlock teen content and see what's in cast mode for these categories and have useful info on how to unlock teens if needed. You can also see this by tapping on a wardrobe like I did and selecting the other age groups option. Okay, now the bookshelf is also interactive. You can read books as you would from any other bookshelves in the same way. And let's just have a closer look. The detail is beautiful. And again, we had that issue where all the wardrobes that we did have had female clothing in it. This would work perfectly for a male sim or your teen. Look at the boxes up top and the frame, you know, the metal frame around it is beautiful. It's very nice. Let's have a quick look at the walnut option here. Exactly the same thing, but of course it's walnut. And perhaps the items in it pop a little bit more in this particular unit. The metal frame around it is lighter against the walnut too. Just ignore this alien. He's in this town for some event of some sort. Right, simple and clean. Let's purchase that. Got wardrobes and some vacuum cleaners. Let's set them down. We've got the stout red vacuum. Let's place it beside the walnut collection here. And then we have the walnut wicker wardrobe. Let's put it beside the walnut collection. And we have the pine wicker wardrobe. Let's move it along to this far end here with its family. And then we have the stout teal vacuum cleaner. Let's place it over here, just because. The prices are varied. You've got over 500,000 for the stout red vacuum, and then the other vacuum is 50 social points. The pine wicker is 120,000 simoleons, and then you've got 15 LP for the walnut wicker. I will assure you that the game changers continue to feed back to the team about the prices and how unhappy the players are with that, but it's up to them to decide on bringing it down as we would want them to. The vacuum works the same way as the other vacuum cleaners that we have received in the game, and this walnut unit is quite pretty. I love the curved edges and the legs that it stands on. The pine option is exactly the same. Let's see what she's going to do with that vacuum. You never know, she might move in a different way. How many ways can you vacuum? It's the same thing, my dears. But yeah, this is the pine option. It's lovely, and of course it's coordinated with the other pine option of items that we would have unlocked, and that's the teal vacuum. Let's quickly go ahead and see what else is there to unlock. A new angle, we've got some corner chairs and some shelves. Let's put those down. Let's put the teal over in the corner here, and the peach one would go over in the corner here, just so I can build them up if I choose to. And the triangular pine goes beside here with the pine collection. And we have the white triangular white shelf here. Some prices are coming in at 6 life points and 4 social points. That's great. Not so much for the others. Let's know what you think in the comments down below. This is the peach angled chair. It's beautiful. You can build that up. You'll see that in a minute. And here is the triangular white. That's what it's called, but it's a bookshelf, to be honest. But it's just called triangular white. So you can read from it like any other bookshelf in the game. And the other thing is, when you swing around, you can see it in view, so it doesn't disappear. I like it when they disappear. This is the other option that we have. That's the pine option. And it's more detailed, it's a lot warmer. And here is the angled teal couch or chair, depending on what you want to call it. And then we've got the square seats and circular stories. What's that about? Okay, so this is where you can build them up. You can put as many as you want, create a complete square. No one can get in and sit down. Wouldn't that be fun? We have the round black, set it down here. And that's 8 life points for the next one. And there's the round white. Let's put it over there. 98,000 for the next. Ouch. Well, again, the prices are varied. Some of the sofas are coming in at 2 social points and 6 life points and so on. This is what I've been trying to say. There are some changes, but for some items, not so much. Let's go ahead and just swap these around because I am pernickety and I just want the colors to coordinate in different parts for display purposes. But of course, you can go ahead and set it out the way you want for contrast reasons. So it's a similar kind of shelf with varying detail, obviously round, and you can just click on it and choose an option and your Sim will wander off and sit somewhere to read, preferably right here. And you can see that this can be built up as far as you want it to go. It allows for you to be really creative. I mean, you could create a snake in your living room depending on how interestingly queer you are with your design skills. But it's lovely, it's really nice and casual, you know, informal for a family. The other option is exactly the same, except it's just white and the detail is a different color. Now let's unlock the Studious Sims and let's quickly set those down. We have the Pine Study Computer. I'd love to see what those look like. They look quite nice. Let's put it over here with a pine set. And we have the oak study. Oh, that looks lovely. We then have some oak desk curios. So I would set it up on a table, but there isn't a point because I don't want anyone to think that a table I put down is part of what was unlocked. And these are the prices. Let me just put that down. But these are the prices. You can see that they are varied, but $310,000 is too much for a study computer. That's just ridiculous. Anyway, here we are with the oak study desk. I think that's really nice. The sharp features of the computer itself looks quite lovely and it's a very tidy setup. We also have the walnut study curios. It's just a stack of books with some bookends and a headphone on a stand. It's quite nice. I love the computer desk, but I really wish we were able to put something up on the side of the desk where the red book is. Well, this is the other option. I love the white drawers on the side and the beautiful desk lamp. It's a soft pink. And of course, the white curios option on the floor with a headphone and a stand and so on. Lovely. Let's go ahead and unlock the next pack. It's called Making Up. Let's quickly put those down. We've got the pink cosmetics set. That's fun. I don't know if these can be interacted with, but let's put it down there. And it's 94,000 simoleons. I don't think so. I don't think it's worth it. And then we have the white cosmetic set here. Well, for 7 social points, that's not so bad. Then we have the computer shelf, or is it shelf computer? The pine one anyway. And then, wow, 360,000 simoleons. And then the walnut shelf computer, I think I'll set it over here, would cost 35 social points, right? So this would work well for your teenage bedroom. You know, you've got that small space in your small house and you want it to work with all the things that your teenage or preteen child might need. So this would work perfectly in a corner and conserve the space. And it's got a lot of bits and bobs on it, including a plant. Now let's have a look at the other one. Of course, it's the Pine Choice, same thing. Depending on your taste, it just means that there's something for everyone in the collection, so to say. Okay, for 94,000 simoleons, what can we do with this makeup set? Nothing. I'm tapping on it and the Sim has just walked across. Can't do anything with it. This is the thing that irritates me a little. You can't really do something incredible with it and it costs a fortune. It's too much. It just is too much. And some things are okay. Let's quickly go in and see what else there is to put down. Room refresh. These are the double beds that we were teased with on Twitter from the Sims Freeplay team. And we've received quite a ton of fabulous and luxurious 3x3 beautiful beds. But space was an issue, right? In some of the small homes and the small plots that we've got. But these are gorgeous. So as usual, the first one is free. We'll look at the prices in a second and let's just set down the other bed. let me just move this along right here. We then have the gray wicker side table. Let's set it down there. And the pink wicker side table. We've got the hot pink neon lights. Set it down here. And we have the salmon pink neon lights. Okay, some lights are ridiculously expensive, and the bed for 375,000 simoleons is just astronomical. I mean, if they're gonna have these prices, they have to do something else, like sitting and reading together in bed, or talking in bed, or eating in bed. Something that makes it worth that price. It's just a bed, and the Sims are gonna do the exact same thing inside of them. I mean, look, same thing. Well, besides the pillows disappearing. I wouldn't want to pay that much money just because my pillows disappear. They're gorgeous beds. They're really nice. Let's see what else we can put down. College is calling. Oh, we've got the single ones. We've got the single ones, people. We also wanted decent single beds. Let's see what they look like. One of the things I was hoping for with the single beds, and these are beautiful, is that we would have them this gorgeous as bunk beds, and also have the preteens use them along with the teens and adults. I think that's a good idea. I mean, how hard can it be? But that being said, it's only the Sims Free Play team that know how hard it is to deliver what we ask for. So we've got to take what we have. We wanted double beds that were gorgeous. We've got them. So we'll be patient and we will wait. Right. I'm just swapping these around because I need to. And then I'm putting down the lime green neon light over there, and the mint green over on this table here. Here are the prices for you to digest. The first pink wicker single bed is 220,000 simoleons. I just think that's ridiculous. It just really is. It's a lot of coins for a, say, a new player. That's a real turnoff. All right, here we are. But I'm not going to ignore the fact that some prices are considerably reduced, especially those that would cost simoleons. Well, sorry, those that would cost social points and life points. You know, items costing as low as 2 social points is amazing. It's a big change, isn't it? Well, the last thing for us to unlock is the final grand prize, which is the family home. Again, don't forget to look in the description down below in this video for links to other videos associated with this update. There will be a live tour of this house in another video, as I say. And better still, just refer to the latest updates early access playlist on the channel, and you get to watch the entire update in one go, and you won't miss anything. The other thing is, if you're new to the channel and you want to subscribe, please do so, and don't forget to click the little notification bell on the side so you're notified as soon as a video goes live. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again soon in the next video. Bye.